Hi everyone, it's me Sanjari and welcome back to my channel Simply Sanjari. Hope you all are doing well. In today's video, I'm going to review another newly launched product by Lermure. I guess you all must have seen by now. So today I'm going to review their Bouncy Jelly Lip and Cheek Stain. And if you guys are interested to know my thoughts, then please stay tuned till the end of this video. And by chance, if you like my video, then please make sure to like, share, subscribe to my channel. Alright, so when I saw Milk Makeup launching their jelly tint, I was so excited that I shared their post in my story and then they reached out to me. I told them, Milk Makeup, please come to India because you have some amazing stuffs to try out. And you can read out the conversation over here, which I'll post it. And today, I am going to review India's first of its kind Lermure Bouncy Jelly Lip and Cheek Stain. Now, if I'm late to review this product, then I'm really very sorry, you guys. But I was trying this product for past few days, and before I share my review, I want to make sure that I note down each and every point so that I don't forget when I'm reviewing it. So yes, let's talk about the packaging. So this is how the outer packaging looks like, which is really very standard from Lermure's end, and you get four shades to choose from. It retails for ₹8.95 for 4 grams of product, and also you get 3 years of shelf life. As you already know, Lermure is completely vegan, cruelty free, paraben free and a clean brand, and the shade that I picked up for myself is Rosy Glow. So that was all about the outer packaging. Now let's have a look at the inner packaging, which actually looks like this. You can see the brand name printed over here, and it comes in a beautiful aesthetic simple beige packaging, which I totally love. You can find the shade name on the bottom of the inner packaging, and when you open the cap, it comes with a protector and you just have to retract it to, you know, bring out the product. And this is how actually the jelly tint looks like, and this is how the shade Rosy Glow actually looks on my skin tone. Okay, so coming to my final thoughts, as I've already mentioned that the texture of these jelly tints actually feels very bouncy, squishy and jelly like, and once you apply it to the cheeks, you'll get that cooling sensation, which I totally love. It also has extract of watermelon and aloe vera to boost hydration and give some amount of moisturization, and also it has vegan collagen that is going to give you an illusion of firm skin. The formulation of these water tints is very lightweight and non-sticky and feels a lot more pigmented when you touch it, but once you layer it onto your skin, it gives you a very beautiful sheer to light color payoff. And because these tends to set immediately, so you will really have to be quick with your blending aim. You can directly apply it to your cheeks and then blend it out with your finger. However, I have noticed that I like the finish more with my brush as well as with the sponge, because it gave me a very airbrushed looking skin. It is best to use these kind of products under your powder and over your cream products to avoid any kind of mishaps. I have also noticed that on my bare skin, I really had to build up the product couple of times to actually show up on my brown skin. But if you're light to medium skin tone, I am sure that you do not need so many layers. But when I tried it on top of my foundation with a brush as well as with a sponge, I just had to go with 1 to 2 layers and I was done. And it gave me a very beautiful naturally flush of color, which actually looked amazing in real life. Another important point I wanted to mention over here, that please do not twist up the product entirely, otherwise it is going to come off, because the product itself is not stuck to the surface of the packaging, and it happened with me that I twisted up completely and it fell off. So this kind of mishap can happen anytime, anywhere. So to avoid any kind of contamination or, you know, damaging of the product, you really have to twist as much amount is needed. Now you can say that I have totally stained my fingers completely and it does not come off whatsoever. This makes that it is kind of long wearing, because I have tried this product for 5 to 6 hours on my skin because I was wearing my makeup for that long. But I'm pretty much sure that it is going to be more long wearing, and you can stretch it for more hours unless and until you are wearing your makeup. And once you are done applying the product, please do not forget to put the protector back, because if you fail to do so, it can dry out the product completely and then it will be a waste, because these kind of product tends to dry up pretty quick. So For that reason, they have given the protector. So please do not lose it, because I am someone who is very clumsy when it comes to these kind of minor things. So I really have to be careful myself, and that is why I am warning to you guys. Another point skipped my mind, that is, it comes off really very easily once you remove your makeup using any micellar water or cleansing oil. And I have also noticed that it did not stain my cheeks or my eyes or my lips in any ways. It just comes off really very easily without taking much of an effort. And if you are using just water to remove it, it is going to lighten or fade away the stain, but it is not going to completely remove it off. So you will have to have a good oil-based cleanser or a good oil-based micellar water to remove these kind of stains. So I'm totally happy and convinced with this new launch by L'Oréal, and I would highly recommend you trying it out once if you haven't already. I know it's a bit pricey, but keep in mind that this is an Indian made brand. Everything is made under one roof. Nothing is sourced from outside. And no, this is not a sponsored video. I have got this product from my own money, and there are many products by L'Oréal that I love personally, which I have already reviewed on my channel. So yes, this product gets a total thumbs up from my end. Now it's the time for the swatches. I'll give you the swatches with and without makeup. Basically, it will be on my bare skin and with the foundation on, so that you can decide for yourself which shade to go for. If you are close enough to my skin tone, I think this shade Rosy Glow will look totally flattering on you. So let's get started. Alright you guys, it's a wrap for today. Hope you found the content helpful and informative. If you did, please take a moment to like, share, subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to hit the bell button. You can also follow me on my social handles, whose link I have mentioned it in the description box. Please come and say hi, and I will see you soon with my next one. Till then, bye bye, take care.